Monday, March 1st. I can't believe it. Today is actually one of my best friend's birthdays. So it's a super fun day for me. So I'm very excited for today. But I wanted to talk to you a little bit about me and Mr. Mitchell. So this monstrosity, and this is why we are vertical today instead of horizontal. This is me and Rob's love fern. If you watched 10 Days to Lose a Guy, How to Lose a Guy in 10 Days, love fern came from that. Mr. Mitchell, Rob bought me a plant when we first started dating in 2002. And it was a little tiny thing, little tiny leaves. I had just told him that, you know, I always walk in a giant and the first thing I want to do is like buy the plants that are there because they always look so good and they always have some cute little flowered ones. And so he went into Giant and bought me a plant. And so this little plant came in a 4-inch pot and had like 4 leaves on it. It was very small. This is how tall it is now. So this is me standing at 5'6", and this is just continues to go. So my mug that I wanted to share with you is a mug from the place where we met, which is our workplace. So we worked together at IntelliMark. It was one of my first jobs as soon as I graduated college. And so we met each other there. So, and I put in it a very special drink. So Rob used to like to go to Starbucks all the time. And so I didn't like coffee. So I had to figure something out because I had to change what I normally do, which is not drink coffee, to drinking something at Starbucks. So I started drinking chai lattes. And so this is Bengal spice tea, and I frothed some coconut vanilla milk in it, and then I sprinkled cinnamon on top. So one of my favorite drinks that I get, so it's very nice. So anyway, that's what I wanted to talk about today, adapting and changing. And actually, Pastor Brian just did on his podcast on Thursday, if you haven't listened to it, I think it's a very good listen, on Thursday last week, about adapting and changing. I'm gonna use the same verse. James 1:2, consider it pure joy, my brothers and sisters, whenever you face trials of many kinds, because you know that the testing of your faith produces perseverance. Let perseverance finish its work so that you may mature and complete, not lacking in anything. And so one of the things that's so important about this love fern is it's so representing of our relationship. So I would consider the bottom half all the way to like right about here. You see where it kind of crooks right here? This is where something very specific happened. And that would be our pursuit and our relationship changed to where we were not really in Christ in our relationship. And then became the changing point where God said, I'm not going to let you continue on the way that you are, and you're going to change, or it's not going to be. And that was a very, difficult time and difficult journey for both of us that many people in the church have walked us through. And so that's where this little bend is. So on up further, we got married, and on up further, we had kids. And then if you notice, I think it's hard to see from up here, this very top part right here, like the leaves are actually completely black and burnt. I would call this COVID. Rob and I, we don't typically have a lot of fights, but we just stopped talking to each other. We just stopped altogether. He's building stuff in the basement. He built an office down there because he works from home now. And he built a movie theater room. And so where we would normally come up and at the end of the night we'd be in our bedroom, we have like a little sitting area. We'd both be in there watching TV or talking to each other. We didn't do that anymore because he would stay downstairs and then I would just go upstairs and do my thing. And I'd watch TV or talk to myself or do work. And so we just weren't talking. And so finally, it got to a point where I was like, we gotta talk. And so we sat down. We had this like 4-hour long conversation. Honestly, it was like one of those conversations where you don't want to end, but like you feel like you have to end it because you're so tired of talking. But it was such a good conversation and it was so good for both of us in our relationship. And then you can see obviously the new growth that's come from there. And it's been so great, you know, just getting to relearn some things about my husband and different things that have changed now because of COVID. And so while we're each going through this journey and it affects us differently, there are those around us that either live with us or that are very close to us and can see the changes that are going on in us. And I think it's healthy and good to talk about them and to bring them out into the open. And sometimes we don't always do that. So thank you for joining me this morning, and I continue praying for all of you and just hearing a little bit about our journey and how God has brought us through so many things. Honestly, this love fern does not represent it all, but it definitely has represented a lot, and so it's so important to us and just the way God has intervened in our lives. So I pray that that message blesses you, and I pray that you just continue on talking and changing your life to more like Jesus. Have a great week.